Praxis Prepper.
Hey YouTube, this is Praxis Prepper. River and I are out doing some mining at this rock outcropping right now, and I figured while he's up to that, why don't I look around and see if I can find a quick wild edible to share with you, and I found a really good one. It's right over here behind me, and it's this big bush right here. This is called sweet fern. Now, when I say wild edible, I don't mean that you're necessarily going to go and start eating the leaves, though you could. What this is really good for is making teas and things like that. You can make sun tea or just put it into boiling water, and it makes a really good sort of trail tea, if, you know, for the end of the day. It's kind of a sweet sort of quality to it, and has all the general nutritional benefits of having tea with a little bit of volatile organic oils and things like that in there that are just, you know, good for the whole body. You're going to find this mostly in sort of rocky, kind of arid soils that are pretty well drained and don't have a lot of organic organic content in them. So it grows really well under power lines, which is one reason why I'm not going to like actually collect a lot of this, because I know they spray defoliants and things occasionally here. Isn't that the way? It's like the best wild edibles oftentimes grow in the worst places that you wouldn't want to actually eat anything from. They, you know, grow from like garbage dumps and the cracks between pavement and stuff like that, and under power lines. But sweet fern is a really tasty treat. If you're ever out on the trail and you find it, I'd highly recommend trying to make some tea out of it, because it's just really tasty. And also, oftentimes I'll just grab some of it and just sort of rub it on me. It's supposed to keep the mosquitoes away, and I think it just smells really, really nice. It's one of my favorite things to come across when I'm hiking, and you can smell it usually before you even see it once you get used to what it smells like. So that's it. Anything that I say, always make sure you double check in your own plant identification book. This should be common procedure no matter what you're doing, and get your own plant identification book, because there's so much out here beyond this and all the other things that I've talked about so far that are just waiting for you to pick them up. That's it. Thanks for watching.
Please subscribe and tune in every Friday at 4:30 New York time for a new video.